In this week's parsha, Parshas Kitava, the Torah introduces us to the mitzvah called bikkurim. A person has fruit grow in his land, the first fruits, he ties a ribbon around and then brings them to Jerusalem and gives them to before the Kohen. The Medrash says something fascinating. On the first verse in the Torah, it says bereishis. And the Medrash says the world was created for reishis, bishvil reishis, for the first fruits. The whole world was created for the mitzvah of bikkurim. Really? The mitzvah to tie a ribbon around the fruit, give it to the Kohen? The whole world was created for that? What can this possibly mean? The Vilna Gaon tells us is that the world was created to help for us to confront our challenges, to overcome our tests, to overcome our yetzer haras. The two main yetzer haras, says the Vilna Gaon, are gaiva, arrogance, and taiva, physical desires. The world was created for bikkurim because bikkurim attacks these two yetzer haras. Here you have a person, he worked so hard, he planted the field, he put in the things that himself, it grows. Hashem says, don't eat it. Take these first fruits, bring them to Yerushalayim and say, Kochi va'otzem yadi, my hands, my power did not make this fruit. This all comes from Hashem. It requires us to overcome our arrogance, our gaiva, and to be truly humble. Remember, even though they were our efforts, Hashem is the one that provided this blessing. And then imagine, a person worked so hard to work on these fruits, and then a beautiful apple starts to grow. But it's his first fruit, so what does he do? He ties a ribbon around it, and he watches it start to ripen. And Hashem's telling him, see that apple with the big red ribbon around it? Looks great. You worked on it for a long time, didn't you? Look, but don't touch. Sound familiar? Remember Adam? Adam Harishon in the Garden of Eden, Hashem tests his physical desires by saying, you see that tree? Looks beautiful, right? But there's some things in this world you could look, but don't touch, you can't eat it. Bikkurim also tests our taiva, our physical desires. It might look great, you might really want it, but sometimes Hashem says you have to say no. You have to work on your yetzer hara and break your taiva. The world was created for bikkurim because these two main yetzer haras, gaiva and taiva, arrogance and physical desires, are specifically tested by the mitzvah of bikkurim. Hashem should give us the strength to internalize these ideas, to overcome all of our yetzer haras, and really fulfill what we're supposed to do in this world. Shabbos.